Rigging a character is difficult. There's no way around it. When you start putting a character together for Character Animator, for animation, and you spend all this time getting your artwork just right and looking exactly like you want, and then you bring it in and suddenly the eyes start doing wonky things, or only one of your arms is dragging around, or various other weird issues that we've all seen happen to our characters before. And so what are your options? Well, you can go to the official Adobe forums and ask questions. You can write to me on Twitter or YouTube, as a lot of you do. But a lot of times these are very specific issues, and wouldn't it be great if there was a little more guidance inside the app to help you understand where some potential problem areas might be? And that is what we've done in this latest release. So in rig mode, you'll notice there is a new little icon in the bottom toolbar down here, this little warning looking icon. And if I click on this, it brings up a new little panel called rigging issues. And what this is going to do is scan through my puppet and tell me some common issues or things that we've noticed just by kind of going through your structure and saying, hey, this behavior is missing a tag somewhere, or this is something you probably want to add to your character, or this needs to be independent or whatever. It's not everything. It's not going to be totally comprehensive, but it hopefully is a step in the right direction and will help you understand and fix some of the more common issues that you might run into. So in this video, I'm going to walk through rigging issues for this puppet. Colton McGuffin is his name, this little black and white suited guy. And he's got a few issues, both in his standing version and a walking version. This does not look good at all. So we're going to walk through each of these and kind of go through the issues that this particular puppet is facing step by step. And hopefully through that process, you'll understand how this rigging issues pane works, and it will help you when you are troubleshooting and trying to fix things with your own creations. All right, so let's start with the stationary version of this character, and let's go to our rigging issues panel down here and bring it up. Now, sometimes if you don't have an active scene with this character, you're going to see a dialogue like this. Basically, we need this character to be able to be running in an active scene so we can analyze it and see if things are working properly. So because I was just showing you the walking example, this is saying that that was the last active scene. So if I go to record mode now, that's what I'm seeing. But we want to do the stationary one. So instead, if I go to stationary and double click on this, now this is the active scene. And I could have done this by also clicking that little open button down there in the rigging panel, and that would have gotten me to this scene as well. But now that this is open, we have an active character that Character Animator can analyze in real time and understand if things are working right or wrong. So going back to rig mode, and yeah, as expected, now I see all my issues listed. The nice thing about this is all the things on blue here, you can click. And so left arm, I can click this, or left pupil or whatever, and it's going to select the relevant artwork over here and layers. So it really just helps kind of streamline the fixing process. And so if you had a lot of issues, let's say you had, you know, 10, 15, 20 of these issues, it'd be pretty easy to just kind of click through these, fix the issue and move on. Next to each issue, you're going to see a little sentence that's going to tell you what the problem is, what we think it is, and how you might be able to fix it. So let's walk through this together and see if I can fix our little friend here. All right, so left arm, arm is missing a handle tagged as left wrist. Well, yeah, I can see that I've got my left shoulder, but if I have the arm IK behavior added to a character, you also want to have the elbow and the wrist. So let me tag this handle as a elbow, and I will tag this one as a wrist. And you'll notice that as I'm doing this, things are updating down here. It's going to analyze things in real time and say, okay, you've made a change, or you added another mistake to it. And it's going to keep adding or subtracting the issues or editing them based on what you've done. So now I still have an arm IK issue on my left arm, but it says arm has no wrist or elbow handle tagged as draggable. Well, normally with arm IK, you want the arm to be draggable, right? You want to be able to drag it around with your mouse or fingers on a touch enabled device. Normally, I'm going to do that in the wrist. So I'm going to select the wrist tag here, this handle that's tagged as left wrist, and I'm also going to tag it as draggable. And by doing that, that issue gets erased. So as soon as you fix an issue, it's just going to go away automatically. And that just makes it easy. Now, if you see something that you really don't care about, let's say this breathe thing, handle tagged as breathe is not being used by any behaviors. Okay, so in my body, I do have a handle named breathe here. Is that hurting anybody? Not really. In some cases, having a rogue tag somewhere here or there can run into issues. But for the purposes of this character, this really isn't that big a deal. So what I could do is just roll over this and click the X, and that's going to dismiss it. So sometimes you'll see a suggestion or something that you know how it works and you're doing something different and you want to just dismiss that, just click that X on the right. And if for some reason you made a mistake, you can always go up to this little ellipses icon and say restore ignored issues, and that's gonna bring it up. And so let me just get rid of this the correct way. And now that's going to go. All right, so you can see how fast I'm able to move through this and fix these issues. So left pupil, select that. It says eye gaze, layer tagged as left pupil is not independent. That's right, we want our pupils to be independent. So I'm gonna add the little crown icon next to this, and that is going to make it that issue go away. And the last one, it says nutcracker jaw, no layers or handles with required tags could be found. Remove the behavior if not needed. Again, this is something that isn't that bad. It's not really hurting the puppet because I didn't have any jaw movement for this character, but let's click on this and it's gonna actually click the top level group up here, Colton standing, because that is where the nutcracker jaw behavior was added for some reason. So I can just take this, click the little menu icon over here and go to remove behavior. And now that's going to go away. Okay, so now it says no issues found. I can feel pretty confident that this character is, you know, it passes the basic tests of some basic structural issues. So if I go back to my scene, let's close that panel again. And I can either do that by clicking the icon down here or clicking the X in the upper right corner. Let's go back to our scene. So yeah, now I can see going back to this that it looks like the pupils are working correctly. As I look around, move my head, all of that stuff, everything is working, and I can now drag both hands as well, and they're working with the arm IK behavior. So again, this is not going to solve every problem. There can still be lingering issues with your character, but at least this is kind of a base level checklist that when you are finishing up a rig of a character, it's a good idea to just open this up, go through the list and say, yeah, I can ignore that, or yeah, I forgot to add this tag, and just go through the process. It's a nice sanity check, if nothing else. All right, so now I'm gonna move into the walking version of this puppet. And I'm doing this just because walking is a very common thing that we get a lot of questions about. It's kind of complicated, right? When you look at, you know, all the different parts that you have to have tagged, shoulders and waist and elbows and all of that stuff, it can get pretty complicated. And so hopefully this will help make walking a little bit easier. So I'm gonna click on my rigging issues and let's go through all of this. Okay, so Colton walking. Puppet is missing symmetry, found handle tagged as left heel, but no other handle tagged as right heel. Okay, so in this case, all of these are kind of looking at the top level of the puppet. So it's looking at wherever the behavior is added. In this case, walk has been added at this top level up here. And so it's saying, you know, it found one version of this tag. So it found a left heel. But if I go to my right leg, I notice, oops, I forgot to add a right heel. So I'm just going to do that real quick. Let's add a handle right there. And let's call that the right heel. And that looks like that took care of that issue. Okay, another symmetry issue, tagged as right shoulder, but no other handle is tagged as left shoulder, all right? I put my shoulders in the body. That's what you wanna do when you're doing a walk behavior. So I see a right shoulder, I forgot to add the left shoulder. Let's click on that, and that's going to take care of that issue. Okay, puppet is missing a handle tagged as neck. Okay. So most times with the neck, I want that to also be the same as where the head is tagged, which is this origin on the head group. So I'm going to select my head group, select the origin handle here, and I'm also going to tag that as a neck, and that's going to help the head bob up and down as you walk. Now, these next two are pretty harmless. It says handle fixer and dragger. None of these layers, no layers are using these behaviors right now. So if I look at, you know, my character, It's got this, the dragger behavior. It also has this behavior called handle fixer, which you might not really notice that much. It really doesn't come up in a lot of things, but basically that's what's looking for the fixed handle. So when you add, you know, for a static character, when you take a, you know, this pin tool and say, I want this character to be fixed to the ground, that's what you'd be looking for. That's the behavior that keeps them pinned to the ground. It kind of happens behind the scenes, and that behavior does not show up in record or streaming mode, so you don't see it that often. But it's there nevertheless, and for a walking character whose feet we don't want to be fixed on the ground, there's really no reason for this behavior. So I could just do the menu icon, click on that and say remove it. Or I could just ignore that behavior. It's really not, or ignore that warning message. It's, again, it's really not that big of a deal. And the same thing is kind of true about this. I don't have any draggers in the arms because he's walking, and I don't want to drag the arms. I want the arms to move on their own with the walking animation. So for this one, I'm just going to ignore this. It's okay to keep that behavior in there. But if you wanted to streamline your character and get rid of that behavior, you absolutely could as well. Okay, so everything is looking good here. So let's go back to our walking scene. So yeah, already I can tell this is a lot better. His arm isn't super elongated, moving to the side. His feet look like they're moving more or less correctly. I'd probably want to swap this arm around, but that's a separate artwork thing. Overall, this is working great. So yeah, that's it. That's all there is to it. So it's a simple tool, but hopefully a very helpful one in letting you fix some of these common issues and get your character up and running and remove some of the guesswork from the already, you know, pretty difficult rigging process. Hopefully it makes life a little bit easier and a little bit simpler. If you have any questions about the rigging issues panel, or you have ideas on how we could improve this, this is just the 1.0 version and we want to make this better. So if you have ideas of, hey, I wish it checked for this, or I constantly run into this issue. If this was part of the rigging issues panel, this would save my life. Then please post in the official Character Animator forums. We would love to hear about your thoughts and ideas about that. And if you make anything cool with Character Animator and the rigging issues panel helped save your puppet from, you know, head deflation and all of that stuff, we'd love to see that too. Please use hashtag Character Animator when sharing your creations on social media. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching and have fun.